making it another special event and not just like, you know, a photo shoot that you have to do, and really just like celebrating the day.
Welcome to Say Yes to the Best, where we talk to the best wedding pros to give you wedding planning advice. Subscribe on YouTube, follow us on Instagram and Facebook. We have new content out all the time to help you with your wedding planning. Today I'm talking with Morgan of Morgan Taylor Artistry. She's an amazing photographer in the Philadelphia, New Jersey, New York markets. And we're going to talk a little bit about engagement sessions today. Morgan, how are you?
Good. How are you, John?
I'm doing great. We got to work on a really fun shoot highlighting some engagement session locations and wedding portrait locations in Philadelphia. So I really wanted to pick your brain about engagement sessions and, you know, what couples should be thinking about. So just kind of to start off the conversation is, why should a couple have an engagement session?
That's an awesome question. We love the engagement session, and we actually chose a while ago to include it in our packages because we felt like some couples weren't choosing to do it, and we really wanted them to, because it's really awesome for them to have a chance behind not just a camera, but our camera. Many people have had even bad experiences, even if it's like just a phone photo that like kind of, you know, didn't turn out good and whatnot. And so for them to really feel confident and like the photos are going to be, you know, not just of seeing photos of other people from us, but of themselves before the wedding day, it puts them at a lot more ease. And also they're able to kind of fall into the poses a little bit more just easily because they've already been posed by us. And the biggest thing too is on an engagement session, we have so much time with the couple to really go through every single pose. And then on the wedding day, we really just pull from the poses that worked best on them, that they seem the most comfortable in. And it's just also a great time to get to know each other, and it just makes the experience more personable, and couples seem way more comfortable when they've had an engagement session before the wedding day.
I always think it's a great idea, just because, you know, on your wedding day, your photo and video team, unlike some of the other vendors, they're with you pretty much the whole day, and you're probably going to see them more than anyone else other than maybe your significant other. And in some cases more, because we're there in the getting ready portion and they're not. So getting to know someone, I think it's going to really help, because you don't want to find out that, you know, you vibe or you don't vibe on your wedding day. You like to kind of know that going in, I'm sure.
Yeah, absolutely. There's both the two of us for the engagement session too. So they get to meet both of their photographers. And like you said, we're with them all day. I mean, even if they have a wedding planner or coordinator, we're still, you know, your planner, your videographer, and your photographer spend most of the day with you. So it's good that everybody just feels comfortable together. And, you know, it's almost like we're hanging out with them rather than like, you know, more of a vendor, I guess.
One thing that I think a lot of couples kind of worry about with engagement session is, what do you wear compared to a wedding day where you know you're going to wear your wedding dress, you know you're going to wear whatever suit or tux you're going to be in on your day. You actually have to make active choices of, you know, what you're going to do as far as what you wear, and even hair and makeup. So what do you recommend to couples as far as what they should look like when they are having their engagement session done?
We always tell them girls that they should get their hair and makeup done. And this, you know, from personal experience, even like, you don't want to have a bad hair day, you know, on the day of your engagement session or photo shoot or whatnot. And that always seems to be the day that you can't just get it just right. And also, especially like makeup, there are so many tricks that they use just to make your makeup look that much better on camera. And, you know, it might feel a little bit heavy, but it's going to translate more natural onto the camera. So I think it's a great time, especially to get to know those other vendors who might be a part of your wedding day too, your hair and makeup team, and get to use them for your engagement session. And then as far as like what to wear, we encourage two outfits a lot of times, just to maybe do something a little bit more formal and then something slightly more casual. We like to send them a style guide that basically just goes over what we recommend you do, and to kind of match, but not match, more of a coordination where you kind of accent each other's outfits, and, you know, not that super matchy, like, gap look, you know, and just really highlight each other and look your best.
So how should a couple go about choosing what location they are going to go to and have their photos in for an engagement session?
We usually will send them like a questionnaire to ask them what they're looking for, if they're like wanting a mountaintop, the city, a winery, all those different ideas, and kind of pick their brain of what they're thinking. I would say most of our couples don't have like an exact location, but they have an idea of where they would like to have their session. And then also the time of season really, you know, plays into where we are going. Normally for like the winter or something, I would recommend like either the city because there's so much architecture and you're not focusing so much on the foliage, or somewhere like Longwood Gardens because it's beautiful all year round. And then, you know, for the spring and summer and fall, it's like normally fair game, and we just kind of see what their idea of their perfect engagement session is and where it is. And then we'll just look at the location or send some suggestions. And we encourage a good amount of foliage, but also architecture to kind of just give your session more dynamics. So whether that be a park that also has some architecture in it, or, you know, the city, or, you know, even if there's a really cool private location they have some kind of access to. We really like to encourage them to kind of think outside the box and, you know, pick somewhere that like really would be magical.
And if you're not sure, as I mentioned at the top, we put together a video and a shoot kind of highlighting some of the best locations in Philadelphia. So if you're interested in going into the city of Philadelphia for your engagement session, check that out. The information is going to be in the description below. So hopefully that can help you see a real couple in a bunch of different locations in the city. How do you recommend your couples utilize the photos after the engagement session, after they're delivered? You know, what are some of the best uses of that content?
A lot of our couples use them for save the dates, and that usually plays into, you know, when they do them. So that's definitely a huge one. We encourage them to print them out for sure, because you likely don't have a photo session of you prior to this. So it's nice to have some, you know, pictures around the house. And then also some couples use them throughout their wedding day, their showers, and they use them for a guest book a lot of times, which is really cool, because then your guests maybe who have seen it online get to experience it in print, and so do you, and kind of get to relive the engagement session on the wedding day. And also maybe getting an album, you know, for your engagement session too, because I feel like we don't get our photos printed enough these days. So, you know, definitely getting them printed and getting to, you know, physically see them tangibly, that's really cool. So yeah, those are some of the reasons. Oh, and on your wedding website too, it's a really cool place to share your engagement photos.
Is there like one specifically unique way a couple's used some of your engagement photos that you can think of?
Well, we had not actually an engagement photo, but it was after a micro wedding. Somebody got them a cardboard cutout for their party. That was really unique and cool to see.
The cardboard cutout, that's definitely unique. I've never seen that. That's cool.
It was definitely a shock when I saw my photo that large too.
Kind of going a little bit back to what couples should wear, should they consider anything as far as their color scheme for their wedding, if they're planning on utilizing the photos in some of the ways you mentioned, like as part of their guest book or as part of the decor of their actual wedding day?
We kind of try to encourage them to do what they want, because it's also a really cool time to do something different than your wedding day. So having them think about it beforehand of what they're going to use it for can definitely play a role. But mainly for their outfits, we just encourage a little bit more muted colors than you might think, just because it's so bright on the camera and your printed photos. So just to stay a little bit more neutral and maybe accent with smaller items that have a like big pop of color is something that we encourage couples to do. But really, we talk about that a lot when we talk about the season that they want to do it in, because normally if a couple wants to stick to the same season as their wedding, they're kind of thinking in like the same color scheme and they want it to somewhat match their wedding. And then we have couples who are like, I'm getting married in summer, so I want the fall colors and I want it to be completely different and take advantage of getting to, you know, do another season and therefore like different colors because of the season and everything. So I feel like it depends on the couple. You know, some even with the location, they want to match their venue and kind of have that same vibe. And then other couples want to do something completely different.
What is the number one thing that you think couples kind of need to know or need to think about before they do their engagement session, more than anything else?
I feel like just kind of preparing yourself. So like giving yourself the time to pick out your outfits, to maybe book a hair and makeup session, and, you know, get your nails done and all that stuff, just so that you feel like you don't feel ill prepared and you are just, you know, this day is planned out and maybe you have a date later. But really just kind of making it another special event and not just like, you know, a photo shoot that you have to do. And really just like celebrating the day and making sure that you have everything planned and it's not just a last minute thing. Because I just feel like that puts them at so much more ease and everything like that. And also just to have fun, because, you know, it's a celebration. I feel like a lot of couples, it sinks in that they're getting married after they've had their engagement photos. It really makes everything feel super real for them. So it really is a day like worth celebrating and making sure, you know, you plan it and you make it a special day. And it's not just something that, you know, you stress over that you had to get to save the dates out and you decided to do it last minute or something like that.
So I'm going to take the opposite approach with this question. So say that somebody stumbled across this video. They're literally about to walk out the door to do their engagement session. What's one piece of advice you would give them as they're about to do it?
Relax. Trust your photographer. Every couple is nervous going to the engagement session, pretty much. I feel like every couple always tells us, you know, they're not comfortable in front of the camera. They've never done anything like this. So, you know, you're not alone. And your photographer has probably dealt with, you know, couples that feel exactly like you. So just kind of trust the person that you chose as your photographer. You know, you looked through a lot of their content and you liked them. So maybe while they're posing you, things might feel a little weird or awkward and might not be exactly how you envisioned the engagement session feeling. And it's probably going to look really good if you, you know, like the work that you saw online. So, you know, don't overly stress, because then you tend to look more uncomfortable and in your photos. And so just try to have a good time, because I think for most photographers, they try to provide you with an experience that's fun, and to just kind of lean into it.
Great. Well, Morgan, thank you so much for being on the show and all of that great information about engagement sessions.
Thank you. Thanks for having me. I love watching this show, so it's such an honor to finally be on it and everything.
And thank you for working with me on that engagement project. Again, if you are looking to have an engagement session in Philadelphia, check that out. We hit a lot of famous locations, some a little bit more obscure. So I think it'll give you a good idea of some of the options that you can have if you're heading into Philadelphia for your engagement session.
It was such an awesome shoot, and we really hit like so many awesome locations. And that's the best part of Philadelphia, because the options are endless for your location.
And thank you for watching Say Yes to the Best. Again, subscribe on YouTube and follow us on Instagram. We have new content out all the time to help you with your wedding planning. Thanks and happy planning. We'll